comfortable. If you don't do that, hence grow up is not going to happen. When I'm talking about grow up, I'm talking about this. I'm not talking about this. Many of you, when I'm talking about growing up, you're talking about what we call as a arithmetic progression or a geometrical progression. An arithmetical progression is 1 plus 1, 1 plus 2, 2 plus 4, whatever. It's a very structured year-on-year growth, like 10%, 15%. Last year I did 1 crore, this year I'll do 1 crore, 1.2 crores. I did 5 crores, I'll do 6 crores, whatever. It's called arithmetic progression. A geometric progression is much faster. You are looking at 1x, 1.5x, 2x, 4x, things like that. I did 5 crores this year, let me aim for 20 crores next year. 4x, turnover wise. Grow up really means what? In that sense, if it is AP and GP, what comes next? What is NP? Finally, back to bottom lines. AP is over, GP is over. After that, those who have studied mathematics in 10th and 12th, you should be able to guess. Not a big deal. We talk about exponential growth. The third one, really speaking, if you take it, is AP, GP, then you're talking about exponential. When you are talking about an exponential growth, you are talking about raising something to the power of n. 2 to the power of 2 is different from 2 into 2. 2 to the power of 3, 2 to the power of 4. Exponential growth is when you are taking off like a rocket. Straight. I didn't say grow sideways. I said grow up. Grow up really means your ability to take off straight. To take off straight like a rocket, what do you need? What do you need? What kind of a power? You need an escape velocity. Right? What is an escape velocity? Speed. What is the escape velocity? Speed. Arithmetic progression, geometric progression. Series of notes na ettunagar bolu. How many of you are sure of the velocity, escape velocity? You know, Google bagarara. We're talking about 11.3 kilometers per second. That's when you can escape. Till then the rocket cannot go up. It has to go off. It has to beat the gravity. It has to go beyond that. So it has to really go up where it leaves the satellite in the orbit and goes around. If I'm talking about an escape velocity, it's its ability to fight gravity and go up. In this case, for you, what does gravity do? Pulls back. In your case, when you're going up, who acts as a gravity? Who acts as a gravity who pulls you back? First is you. You are the first gravity for yourself. Then the others. The entire world, one out of prejudice, out of jealousy, out of competition, they want to pull you back. Second, they really don't know that it is possible. Hence they tell you, please, you have been all along doing well, you know, why are you unnecessarily breaking your head? Scale it down. Be practical. All these things start happening. I am not saying that everyone who sets a vision, everyone who is a visionary, everyone who goes up has to necessarily succeed. No, not at all. Recently ISRO sent a rocket 2 weeks back which fell off, PSLV 5 or whatever. It is a possibility that once in a while these kind of efforts will fail. That's why they say the reason why rockets go faster than aeroplane is because rocket has fire at the bottom. Aeroplane doesn't have. Obviously when you put so much of fire, you need to run, you don't have a choice. But in those kind of situations, it is a possibility once in a while the visions can fail. You have not failed. Your vision has failed. The moment we have a failure in life, immediately we attach that to us and we feel it failed because of me. It could have failed because of thousands of reasons. And that past experience of 1, 2, 3 small failures stops you from thinking after that at all. Play it safe. Do what everyone is doing because I can see him making money, I can see him making money. So if I move in, what do? I know for sure there is a portion of the pie available for me. I'll take a little bit out. It may be small, but I'm happy. But how many of us think of, instead of sharing a pie, can I create another pie? Another cake. Why should I go and eat into the same cake? Can I create another cake? Can I enlarge the cake? Can I do something to enlarge the market? Can I do something to create newer market? Can I do something to create newer verticals, newer product segments? Even within the same industry, it's possible for you to create a vision. A vision does not necessarily mean you need to give up what you're doing. I started with a random thought because just to shake you up a little bit. You don't need to give up what you're doing. Even in whatever you're doing, can you create a vision for yourself, which is much larger? Like what the gentleman said, he wanted to become Junaid, right? LG's director 5 years from now. Why not? But it is within the same vertical. He is not moving out somewhere. He is moving within that. Even that is worthwhile. Do we at least have that kind of confidence in us to sustain? It's quite easy in an atmosphere like this where we are free to talk, everyone is sharing. Once I go out of the room, I have even forgotten the paper where I wrote my vision. I don't even know what I wrote. Or when I go out, I said it because, you know, people are looking at me and I felt good sharing. It won't happen. Why I'm saying all this is, I'm going to start now a video. This video is about giving you confidence in situations which can be the most troublesome. It's a rare possibility, you might have seen this video. I have seen this video personally about 300 to 400 times in the last 10-15 years. Every time I see this video, I get different meanings, different motivations, better ways of looking at it. This can be a defining point when you see this video, because what happens inside of you when you watch this video is something different. You'll see someone who fights against all odds to come out with blazing colors in spite of all the challenges they face. And when we finish that video, we'll come back and see whether we have a link between. This is a real story that you're going to see. Something which has happened to somebody. Of course, reshot, it was not created when it happened. It has been rebuilt. When you watch, every frame can be debriefed. Sometimes this video we debrief for 2 to 3 days. We are not going to do all this. We'll just have a minimum amount of discussion and see how we can connect it back to vision and connect it back to that statement, grow up or why do you have to say it? Say, no, that doesn't exist. It's not an option. You are making that option. You just say grow up. Why do you have to say go down? In fact, somebody should object. I only want the first portion, I don't want the second portion. Once the satellite is put into orbit, how does it matter what happens to the rocket? The rocket is your vision which launches you there. Once you are there, you stay there. You don't need to come down. Finally, someday you may become useless. We'll see at that point of time. Can you switch on the... It's a terrific goal that he had on 25th of December, Christmas. I'll walk out of the hospital on my own 2 feet. Okay, then. A lot of learning. I mean, we can talk about it for 2-3 days. Normally, this can be debriefed for so long. What else? Okay, good. You need to be able to visualize what you want and break them into. He says also, in terms of breaking them down into short-term, mid-term and long-term goals. And have, he also mentions about the blueprint for success. Having a very clear plan in terms of a strategy, have a vision, break them down into goals, have a strategy and ensure perfect execution at no point of time. There's also a lot of teamwork involved there, if you really see. He was able to use all the people around him. He had severe limitations, huge limitations when it comes to communication. I mean, many of us in that situation normally would have given up life. He is told very clearly that 1 out of 1,000 people only even get through this operation, leave alone, living after that. Normally the rest, the possibility is that you might not even get out of the operation theater. But even if you come out, it's a possibility that you live like a vegetable for the rest of your life. At that point of time, there is a statement which goes in the background. As his thought, he says, it doesn't matter what the society thinks. Because society leads you towards suicide by making you believe in so many things that they want you to believe in. He said, it doesn't matter what the world believes. I believe I'll be alright. And he also goes ahead and sets in terms of specific goals. And he breaks them down into much more clearer short-term goals. Like, the first goal he says is, the first goal he wants to say is to live, to get out of the operation theater alive. The second goal is to be able to breathe. The third goal is to be able to speak. The fourth goal is to be able to eat. The fifth goal is to be able to start using his limbs. The sixth goal is to be able to get off his crutches. The seventh goal is to walk out of the hospital. The eighth goal is to recover. The ninth goal is to go ahead and shake hands with the doctor who says, I never believed it is possible. And he says, I never believed it is never possible. He always thought it was possible. And the ending is really, the statement that comes out in the bottom is really fabulous. I don't know how many of you saw that or remembered that. What was being said there? Whatever the mind can conceive and believe, it can achieve. What do these words really mean to you? A very powerful statement, not many of us really understand the full meaning. I'll write it down for you first. I would like to see if any of you can really explain what this means. Whatever the mind can conceive and consistently believe it can achieve. I actually modified the quote. Did anyone see the difference? Good. At least one person has observed to start with. I have to get rid of the chocolate dolls. I'll come to the reason as to why. This is my twist to the quote. I won't really explain because this quote needs a lot of explanation for you to understand. What meets the eye is not what you read. This quote is so powerful, I can talk on this quote for the next 1 hour. There's so much to it. So I want to first see if you have understood this quote. This is just one of the quotes that you saw. There are at least 7-8 quotes which went ahead before that. But I want to take on this one single quote because this is sufficient to cover the entire learning. I want you to, it's like in Tamil, like Thirukural. Just two lines, but you can talk on it for hours together if you are really clear about. Yeah? Okay, good. Okay, you're coming somewhere near, but there's still a long way to go, but still a good effort. Only a few people are getting chocolates, not others. Rich get richer, poor get poorer. Who else can really take your hand at explaining this? Very powerful quote. If you are able to put this into use in your day-to-day life, and you can really scale heights which are unimaginable. I am talking in terms of all senses of the world, material, whatever it means. In whatever pursuit that you are after, you will be able to find that this can be one single guiding quote that you can use. If you know the meaning of the quote, and second, if you are able to put it into action. Start giving chocolates. Why are you running away from the chocolate? It's not a cricket ball. To make it easy for you to understand, I will For you to understand the power of this statement, you need to understand all the six words that I have underlined there. We will start with the first word. I have underlined the word whatever. What does whatever mean? After I write, don't say, no, this is what I thought. Sorry? The word whatever here very clearly means limitless possibilities. What do you mean by limitless possibilities? There are no end. Entire universe, the entire, it all starts with a dream. The entire universe is there for the asking. Do we ask? Do we even know that it exists for us to ask? You can make your own pickings, as they say. As they say, the universe has no, I would say, limit to the wealth that it can give you. In any sense of the word, happiness, peace, money, success, you can define what you want. It's not just about money alone. Do we really know that there are no limits? How many of us really even understand, leave alone believe, that limits are, I mean, they know, it's unlimited. Possibilities are unlimited. What I want to pick, I mean, somebody might want to become a great cricketer, it becomes a possibility for him. Somebody wants to become a great businessman, it becomes a possibility. The hundreds of threads that happen in our life, limitless possibilities. At every point of time, I tell people, it's like a train getting out of Central Station. When you get out of Central Station, the first station that you come across is Basin Bridge. The Basin Bridge is where the train or the signaling system decides where the train has to move. On that spot, depending upon where the train moves by a degree, 1 degree, it just moves. You can either land up in Coimbatore, Cochin, Trivandrum, or move to Bangalore, go on to Bangalore, Mysore, or go up a little bit, go up to Bombay, go or take a trajectory, go up to Nagpur, Delhi, go a little bit this side, go to Hyderabad, go a little bit further down, go to Calcutta, Assam. All in that one single moment, the possibilities are enormous. You need to know that the possibilities exist in the first place. Anything that is, that's why I started in the morning, or whenever we start the session, with the word called vision. Because without a vision, the possibilities don't come in. I mentioned that vision leads to possibilities. Possibilities lead to goals. Goals lead to plan, a business plan. A business plan leads to strategization. Strategization leads to execution. Those things come much, much later. Resources, all those things come much later. As far as this learning is concerned from this video, the possibility that exists in front of us is limited. If I have to give you an example, for example, that you have about, say, 1000 crore deposit in your name. You don't have to earn for the rest of your life. This 1000 crores is put in a fixed deposit where you get monthly interest. You are not aware of this. Others are aware, you are not aware. Every day for you to make a living, you go out with a begging bowl, take food and eat. For example, should others laugh at you or cry for you or do both? What should they do? You don't know, others know, but you don't know that you have such a huge deposit or the money is coming and you are actually still begging for alms and then making a living. Should you laugh? Should you cry when you come to know of the fact? Do both. Our life is like this. Limitless possibilities. Many of us are not even aware that anything that you can aim for, it's possible for you to achieve. In fact, some of the other programs we ran earlier, the title I gave was called as Impossible is Nothing. Limitless possibilities mean the entire universe. There is a famous quote. It says, once you decide what you want, the universe conspires to give you that. Conspires is here a positive term. Normally conspire is used for negative connotation. Now we have looked at limitless possibilities. I looked at the word to. Mind, what does this mean to you? Something all of us are bestowed with, all of us have, yet we never realize is the power of the subconscious. We all have subconscious mind free of cost available around the clock. Yet we rarely even know how to get in. That's not the purpose of the program, but this happened in the case of the miracle man. He was able to work on the subconscious, bring out whatever he needed to. He was able to visualize every end before even it started. For example, the nurse was speaking to him. He was thinking himself as if he is at home and he has become perfectly all right. And he was actually getting out of the bed and putting his feet into the slippers. Actually, he was in the hospital. He was able to look at something ahead. Because the subconscious mind does not know the difference between what is real and what is imagined. And whatever you are able to imagine and visualize, it will get for you. This is a part of the subconscious which many of us don't realize. Let's look at the third word. Conceive. What does it mean to you? Not visualize. A dream or a vision or goals. Finally, the ability to conceive is a restriction that I impose upon myself. If I am able to conceive, I can do. If I cannot conceive, I can't. When I ask for a vision, for many of you are struggling because many times many of us have not even done it. We are too busy running after our day-to-day chores. We are busy executing what others have been telling us. We don't even think of something that we can look at something larger. Once you are able to think large, think big, think of a vision, think of a grand goal, then you'll automatically find that your inner strength, the consistent inner power and strength, like what he mentioned, comes to your help, provided the next word, which I introduced, consistently. Why? There is also a key in that video itself. Why consistency is a problem? Why is it a problem? There's a very clear word that comes out there. How many of you remember the meaning of this word, snyop? It was an acronym used. What did it stand for? Susceptible to the negative influences of other people. Susceptible means we are prone to, we are open to negative influences of other people. All along what happens, he also gives the story of the elephant. The elephant, when it is quite young, it is being trained by being chained. It is being chained to the wall or to whatever, and it immediately, initially just tries to kick itself free, and it finds it can't kick itself. It can't get itself free. Once it is conditioned to believe that it can't kick itself out, it stops trying. At that point of time, what do? They take the steel chain and put a normal rope. So mentally, it is now conditioned that I cannot escape. This is what happens with the people around us. Many of the people who are around you, fortunately or unfortunately, are conditioned to believe that they cannot succeed or make it big in life. So when you are around them, what happens? They come and belittle your dreams or visions and they tell you, this is not possible, you can't do it, this is not done. And one person says, okay, second person, third person, five, suddenly I start believing. Tamil, there is a saying, Pattu Dara Sonna, Poyum Unmayadu. People come and tell you repeatedly, it's not possible. I mean, have you ever looked at your face? Is it possible? It's, you know, it's never done. Please leave it. You will unnecessarily fall. Play it safe. No risk taking. All these things happen. Hence consistency, because many of you, when you step out of this room, will surely go to the belief system, for sure. This is what happens in all programs. I will do it. The moment you go back home and start talking to someone, your business partner or colleague or some other industry friend, somebody would have come and convinced you, don't do all this. You will only pay the price. He will come and teach. Who will pay the price? Will he pay for you? छोड़ दो, लीव ऑल दिस, जस्ट फॉलो व्हाट यू आर डूइंग एंड देन नाउ यू आर कन्विंस्ड. अप्पा दिस व्हाट आई आल्सो थॉट, आई वांटेड समवन टू टेल मी आई एम सेंसिबल. गॉन. इमेजिन द पर्सन हु टेक्स द रिस्क एंड देन वी से ही हैड द लक हियर, क्वाइट बिल गेट्स, आई कांट डू ऑल दिस, इट्स पॉसिबल फॉर हिम, दे कैन टेक द रिस्क, आई कांट टेक द रिस्क. The people who have done that are the people who have consistently believed the next word. The belief system again comes from inside. I need to believe consistently irrespective of what happens. I should be able to sort of mentally protect myself from virus attacks. What is the virus attack? The negatives of all the other people of based on the so-called experience that it's not possible to achieve. Hence people, this is what was happening to the miracle man all the time. People kept on saying, nobody has ever come out of this accident alive. Even if you come out of the accident alive, you are not going to make it. Even if you make it, you cannot walk. Even if you are, say for example, able to breathe, you will be confined to a wheelchair. Why do you want to live? I have seen many people where they just give up on life, they just give up on some disabilities or they just give up on some business problem because everyone says it's not possible. The entire world believes that this is not going to happen. So I also believe. The people who have made it big are the people who question that this is not going to happen. I'll do. Either way, what do you lose? Either way, what do you lose? If you continue with status quo, you're going to be what you are. At least if you do something, if you dare to do something different, there is a chance you may become better. After all, many of you had a choice whenever you left college of taking a job safely and working. Easily. Many of you today are business owners because you took that risk and you have moved in. But after that first risk that you took of starting a business, what risk have you taken further? Now you are playing it safe. What happened to that enthusiasm, that belief system which urged, which pushed you into starting something which was there many years back, but what has happened to that? Has the industry sort of beaten you to thinking that it's not possible for you to expand any further, to think big? You have to go back and do, because finally nobody else can take any action for you except yourself. What I can give you is a belief system. For you to act, finally it's your call. Like taking the horse to the water, showing the water is available, making you feel even thirsty, it's a possibility. For you to drink, it's your own call. And finally, followed by action, anything that your mind can conceive, whatever the mind, whatever being, limitless possibilities. Whatever the mind can conceive, the mind, the subconscious mind, can conceive in terms of ideas, dreams, vision. It is possible if you consistently believe, qualitative, of course, because mere armchair thinking is not going to help. Sitting in a chair and thinking that I am going to succeed, I am going to become big, I am going to... That will be good to make you believe it's possible. You need to get down onto the field and get into action. Hence you look at this statement and going back to the topic with which we started. Hence, to grow, what are the topic we started with? How many of you remember? Grow up. Second option is not needed. I am setting a trap to check what you are saying. You thought I have forgotten the topic, is it? The choice is, sorry sir, we have redefined the topic today. At the end of the day, the topic is? All of you will grow up. Thank you. All the best.
So I think everybody has enjoyed the exciting presentations and speech by Prakash. I think he deserves a round of applause again. Thank you so much. Can you have the visiting cards again, because we have some lucky draw here. Few people have, for all our customers. Meanwhile, I call upon Rashik bhai to honor our vendors and distributors who has come on a busy schedule. Please come, Rashik bhai. A small momento, sir. Thank you, Mr. Krishna. Thank you, Rashik bhai. Can we have Mulchan sir? Mr. MC Jain from Mahavir Computers, to please honor Mr. Junaid from LG. Thank you so much. Uttamji from TechPro, please come and Ilai Raja from HP, who handles our commercial business. He's from HP India, Mr. Ilai Raja. Uttamji from TechPro, Thank you. Kushal ji, please come, sir. We have Mr. Sriram from HP India, who handles server category. We would like to Kushal ji to order. Oh, Mr. Ramesh from computer gallery, please. Mr. Sriram from